Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with an important topic, that is hacking by Russia. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is also important from interview point of view. Now in this class we will be learning three things. First of all, how Russia was involved in the United States of America's election. Involvement of Russia and what it exhibits. It means how diplomacy is changing its color, how diplomacy is becoming more dirtier and mercurial. And then we will be understanding why Russia had indirectly supported Donald Trump. Now first of all, let us understand Russia's involvement in United States of America's elections. Now the elections that had recently been conducted in United States of America, it had a fierce competition between two candidates. One candidate belonged to the Democratic Party, and the other belonged to the Republican Party. Now Donald Trump belonged to the Republican Party. From Democrats there was Hillary Clinton. Now Hillary Clinton has communicated certain information via emails. Now the kind of the information that he had shared with the colleagues, it was kind of a malicious information. It was an information which could have tarnished her image. It was information which could have hit at her vote bank. Russia wanted that Hillary Clinton should not be winning the elections. Russia had wanted to support Donald Trump, and in order to do this, Russia ventured into the cyberspace of United States of America, and it had hacked the emails that were sent by Hillary Clinton. Now these emails were made public. These emails had a bearing on the rating of Hillary Clinton. These emails led to the shrinking of the support of Hillary Clinton. The leakage of the information led to the increase in the support base of Donald Trump. This is first time that we are seeing how the superpowers of the world are trying to make diplomacy turn more dirtier. How diplomacy is being used to maneuver the elections of some other country. How the ideological wars, they are taking a new shape. How the Cold War II is unfolding. How the Cold War II phase is allowing the foreign countries to interfere in the election process. Now what has been the result of this? The recent result of this has been that the Barack Obama, that the incumbent president, he has ordered a probe in the hacking done by Russia. And he has ordered this probe not only for 2016 elections, but also for 2008 elections and 2012 elections. Basically, America just wants to know about how foreign powers are trying to influence the election process so that they can construct walls in the cyberspace, so that they can protect their data, so that they can protect how communication is done, so that they can protect American interest in the longer run. The most important thing, why Russia had supported, indirectly supported Donald Trump. Now when it comes to Donald Trump's ideology, his ideology is based on hitting at terrorism. His ideology is based on deglobalizing. His ideology is based on fundamentalism. His ideology is based on increasing the role of state. So basically, any effort that would be done to deglobalize, it would mean that America would be turning to an ideological setup which will be close to that of Russians, because Russians had always believed in the more role of the state. In the past, from 1950s till now, what we have seen was the war between communism and capitalism. The communist forces had always believed in the more role of the state. They were against globalization, they were against free trade, they were against the loss of the jobs for the citizens. This is what is being propagated, this is what is being advertised, this is what is the ideology of Donald Trump. So Russia feels more associated with the ideology of Donald Trump. Russia feels that its system, its vision of the world is more close to that of Donald Trump. And this is the reason why it has supported Donald Trump indirectly. Now there are other reasons, like Russia's invasion of Ukraine. This was something that was heavily contested by United States of America. And this is one of the reasons why United States of America is going against Russian interests in Syria. This is also the reason why United States of America is going against the Russian interests in Iran. And this is also the reason why Russia, Iran, and China have come close to each other. They have formed a group of close-knit friends, and this close-knit group is being countered by the friendship done by United States of America and Japan. So a new kind of equation is emerging in the globe. So this editorial, this class is more important from the perspective of how easy it has become for the superpowers to hack this cyberspace, how to maneuver the election of some other country in some other countries, how to manipulate the elections in some other countries. So the question could be like, critically analyze, keeping in the episode of hacking by Russia of the Democrats' office, how the cyberspace can be protected. Or another question could be like, analyze why Russia has supported Donald Trump indirectly. Or the another equation could be like, visualize what would be the diplomatic landscape after the election of Donald Trump as the President of the United States of America. Now if you want to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is BrainyIAS. In that application you can get brainy maps on the current affair issues, you can get notes on the current affair issues, plus you can also watch current affair classes. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.